So the oldest university and the first university ever founded was founded by a Muslim woman, and her name was Fatima Fihri.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Yasmin Abu Quaik, and with us here today is Rowayda Abdulaziz, a reporter at Huffington Post. She's going to be speaking on Fatima al-Fihri. Can you tell us a little bit about who Fatima al-Fihri is?
Sure. So Fatima al-Fihri was born in a city called El Karouan in modern-day Tunisia. That's where she lived growing up for a short period of time of her life until eventually she got up and her family and they moved to Morocco, where she eventually met her husband and got married. But it was shortly after her marriage that both her father and her husband passed away. And after her death, she inherited a large sum of money. Mm-hmm. And her being well-educated, she actually had a sister named Maryam. They were also really well-educated growing up. Education was definitely a value that was important to the family as a whole. Mm-hmm. Once they got this large inheritance, they both thought, what are a way that they can, you know, respect the legacy of education mm-hmm. that they've been taught as young girls growing up, but also honor their father and honor the city that they came from. Mm-hmm. So both sisters actually went on to find Masajid. And in Fatima's case, she named the Masjid the city in which she came from in Tunisia, in Morocco. And that masjid ended up spiraling into something so much bigger than her. Mm-hmm. She, over the years, added a library. There were tons of books. She realized people were coming to the center for more than just worship. Mm-hmm. And then it became a university that continues to stand today. And I think is an incredible part of Islamic history that many of us don't know about.
So from your personal experience, why do you think education is important for like young Muslims today, especially women?
We definitely know that education is the power to success, mm-hmm. right? And despite the many ways in which we define success, mm-hmm. it is something that is incredibly important to us as humans, it's incredibly important to us as Muslims, mm-hmm. and it's just reassuring to know that it's an Islamic value as well. I think growing up, sometimes we're taught to separate the two, right? Yeah. Our Muslim life and perhaps our everyday life. Mm-hmm. But these are one of the values that are very much intertwined. Mm-hmm. And I think seeing in it the legacy of Fatima is so important, because when we think about prestigious universities, I think especially here in the US, mm-hmm. we think about Western ones. We don't think about this value in an Islamic perspective. And so I think knowing our history and knowing our roots is going to continue to encourage us and motivate us to take this concept of education more seriously. It's not just so we can go to university or find a career or make money, and although those are, you know, values that we should all strive for, mm-hmm. but it is also for enriching our personal lives. And it's something that was important to her legacy, it was something mm-hmm. that was important to my legacy. And I think knowing that these two things are intertwined is so important to us and is so important to tell young people today.
Right. So we all know that Fatima al-Fihri was the founder of the first and oldest university. Why do you think that's something important for us to even know?
I think it's important to know because, unfortunately, we learn about Islam, I think, as Muslims, especially in the US, and I think anywhere in the world, in a way that's very one-dimensional, right? And of course, we learn about the basics. It's incredibly important. We learn about the Sahaba. We learn about the lives of the prophets. But there are so many more inspirational figures that we don't know about. And I think oftentimes, as women, we specifically don't know about other historical women, right? We know about Sittina Khadija. We know about Sittina Aisha. But then it kind of stops there. And maybe it's a limited capacity from the schools, perhaps the certain masajid don't really have the time or are not dedicated to having a well-rounded view. And to be quite honest, I think Muslim women, perhaps sometimes we don't ask. We just take what we learn as basic education and we go with it. So I think it's incredibly important to understand the legacy of women and womanhood in Islam, especially nowadays when our faith has been demonized. Muslim women in particular continue to be seen as oppressed, right? We are continued to told that our faith is one that is regressing, and we're consistently fighting that stereotype wherever we go. And not even just here in the West, you know, in certain cultural practices that are not Islamic. We, you know, we see folks and we see young women being prevented from getting an education in the name of Islam. And I think having the education of what Islam provides us, the opportunities, and not just opportunities, but the examples in history that prove that these are opportunities for us, is incredibly important, because then we know it's our right. Right. And it's not just a privilege. Mm-hmm. And when we know what our rights are, right. we're more likely to go and pursue them. And when you have a community of women that's well-educated, mm-hmm. that knows their rights, that's stronger, mm-hmm. and despite all the cliches and the stereotypes and the challenges, you find that that community is so much more enriched. Right. And we see that in Fatima's legacy. Mm-hmm. Her community, which was predominantly a community of immigrants and folks who have traveled from other countries, and her sister's community, the masjid that she found in Andalusia, in Spain, these were all folks who didn't grow up in that particular environment in those particular cities. But despite that, they found ways to educate themselves and enrich their lives no matter where they went. And I think that's something that is incredibly important for us. And it was incredibly important for me as a daughter of immigrants as well. Mm-hmm. And I think there are so many lessons that we can take away from, especially, I think, as young women. I think one thing that I think about quite often when I think about Fatima's legacy is relating it back to my work.
Right.
You know, as a journalist, it's incredibly important that I have information that's accurate, right. that is enriching. Mm-hmm. This concept of seeking ilm and seeking knowledge mm-hmm. is a value that I do in my everyday in my profession. Right. And I think there's this stereotype about being a person of faith, meaning that you have blindfolds on.
Right.
And that's completely the opposite when we think about Islam and we think about the Islamic values that mm-hmm. we're taught. And this absolutely goes hand in hand in journalism. It's one yes. of the reasons why I love journalism. I love the idea of just being well-informed and to mm-hmm. having a better idea of what's happening all around me at any given time. Mm-hmm. I think it enriches who I am. It enriches my perspective in the world. And I think this should be a value for anyone, especially young Muslims today.